Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss about the basic things of atoms and nuclear physics or nucleus. So let's start the discussion. So after this video you should be able to discuss the early models of atoms leading to the Bohr theory of the atoms. Also you can demonstrate your understanding of emissions, absorption spectra and predict the wavelength of frequencies of the Balmer, Lyman and Pasteur spectral series. Also you can calculate the energy emitted or absorbed by the hydrogen atom when the electron moves to a higher or energy levels, lower energy levels. So इस वीडियो को देखने के बाद आप हाइड्रोजन स्पेक्ट्रा समझ सकते हैं, एब्जॉर्प्शन और इमिशन स्पेक्ट्रा समझ सकते हैं, और उसके थ्रू हम हाइड्रोजन की एनर्जी कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे फ्रॉम हायर टू लोअर एंड लोअर टू हायर एनर्जी स्टेट. प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एटम्स. एटम्स आर स्टेबल एंड इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल. एटम्स हैव केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज विच अलाउ देम टू कंबाइन विथ अदर एटम्स. एटम्स इमिट एंड एब्जॉर्ब इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन विथ डिस्क्रीट एनर्जी एंड मोमेंटम. Early experiments show that the most of mass of an atom was associated with positive charge, that is Rutherford model. Atoms have angular momentum and magnetism. So these are the properties of atoms. Thomson's model for the atoms. J.J. Thomson's Planck-Body model consists of a sphere of positive charge with electron embedded inside. This is the positive pudding and this is the electron. This model explained that most of the mass was positive charge and that the atom was electrically neutral. So the whole atom is electrically neutral by this model, because electron is negative and the other pudding is positive, so the whole atom is neutral. The size of the atoms is nearly 10 per minus 10 meter. Rutherford's experiment. The Thomson model was amended in 1911 when Rutherford bombarded a thin metals with a stream of positive charged alpha particle. Experimental arrangement is like this. Most particle pass right through the foil. Here he is using gold foil. Also there are many other foils are used. So this experiment is not really done by the Rutherford, but it's a collaborators done by the collaborators, that is his students. Because this experiment occurs in Rutherford's laboratory, so its name is Rutherford scattering experiment. So most of the particle pass right. ये experiment Rutherford के lab में किया गया था, इसलिए Rutherford experiment कहा जाता है, scattering experiment. Otherwise exactly Rutherford ने इस experiment को नहीं किया था, इनके scholars थे जो इस experiment को किए थे. तो इनकी lab में ये सारी चीज़ें हुई थी और ये उसके मालिक थे, एक तरह से owner थे, इसलिए जो experiment हुआ वो Rutherford के नाम से famous हुआ. But a few are scattered. Most particles pass through the foils. But a few scattered in backward direction. And this experiment also give the new criteria for the atoms, because in this method we know the atom is not a neutral but it has the positive charge. The nucleus of an atom. If electron were distributed uniformly, particles would pass straight through an atom. Rutherford proposed an atom that in open space with a positive charge concentrated in a very dense nucleus. इलेक्ट्रॉन मस्ट ऑर्बिट एट ए डिस्टेंस इन ऑर्डर नॉट टू अट्रैक्ट इन टू द न्यूक्लियस. चूँकि अल्फा पार्टिकल न्यूक्लियस के अंदर अट्रैक्ट नहीं हो रहा है, इसका मतलब यह है कि जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है वो न्यूक्लियस से कुछ दूरी पर रोटेट कर रहा है या ऑर्बिट कर रहा है. सो दिस इज द न्यूक्लियस एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर रिवॉल्विंग इन सम डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम सम डिस्टेंस. इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ऑर्बिट अकॉर्डिंग टू बोर. कंसिडर द प्लेनेटरी मॉडल फॉर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विच मूव्स इन अ सर्कल अराउंड द पॉजिटिव न्यूक्लियस. द फोर हाइड्रोजन एटम अकॉर्डिंग टू बोर दिस इज द रेडियस ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम. दिस फॉर्मूला गिव्स द रेडियस फॉर हाइड्रोजन एटम एंड दिस इज डन बाय दिस फोर्सेस कूलम्स लॉ एंड सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स विच इज ऑलवेज इक्वल ड्यूरिंग सर्कुलर मोशन. That is Coulomb's law, Coulomb's force and centripetal force. And after comparing these forces, we get the radius of the hydrogen atom. Failure of classical model. When an electron is accelerated by the central force, it must radiate energy. Classically, अगर electron accelerate कर रहा है किसी सेंट्रल फोर्स के थ्रू तो एनर्जी को रेडिएट करना चाहिए. सो देयर इज लॉस ऑफ एनर्जी. सो द वेलोसिटी मस्ट डिक्रीज एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन मस्ट बी क्रैश इनटू द न्यूक्लियस लाइक दिस. बट दिस डज नॉट हैपन एंड द रदरफोर्ड मॉडल वाज फेल. Earlier, we learned that the objects continuously emit and absorb electromagnetic radiation. In emission spectrum, light is separated into characteristic wavelength, and in absorption spectrum, a gas absorbed certain wavelength, which identify the element. So, clear? Emission spectrum for hydrogen atom. This is the characteristic wavelength of emission spectrum. This. Balmer work out a mathematical formula called the Balmer series for preceding the absorbed wavelength from hydrogen gases. This is the formula for the wavelength of absorbed radiation, absorbed spectrum. Example. The question hai, use the Balmer equation to find the wavelength of the first line n equal to 3 in the Balmer series. How you can find the energy? So there is the relation. From here we can find lambda, and after getting lambda we can use the frequency formula for frequency and the energy in the form, and after calculating we can get the energy. The Bohr atom. Atomic spectra indicate that atoms emit or absorb energy in discrete amounts. In 1913, Niels Bohr explained that the classical theory did not apply to the Rutherford atom because classically the atom has a continuous energy level. There is no discrete amount, but atomic spectra indicate that the atoms emit or absorb in discrete amount. So it cannot be explained by the classical theory. An electron can only have a certain orbit, and the atom must have definite energy level which are analogous to standing waves. Wave analysis of orbits. Stable orbit exists for integral multiple of de Broglie wavelength. So 2 pi r equal n lambda, 2 pi r equal to n h upon mb, and from this the Bohr's formula is coming, that is angular momentum equal to mvr, and this is equal to nothing but the n h bar, and that is equal n h upon 2 pi, where n is the principal quantum number, that is equal to 1, 2, 3. The Bohr atom, an electron can have only can have only those orbit in which its angular momentum is this. And when an electron changes from one orbit to another, it gains or loses energy equal to the difference in energy between the initial and the final level. So जो भी energy gain या lose होती है वो equal होती है किसी भी दो states के difference की energy के बराबर. So the difference in energy between initial and final. Bohr's atoms and radiation. This showing the emission and this is absorption. The emission spectrum are absorbed when the higher energy levels electrons are jump into the lower energy level, and the absorptions are absorbed when the lower energy electrons getting some energy and moves towards the higher energy level. When an electron drops to a lower level, radiation is emitted, and when the radiation is absorbed, the electrons moves to a higher level. And the energy is the difference between the two levels, that is the initial level and higher energy level. By combining the idea of energy level with classical theory, Bohr was able to predict the radius of the hydrogen atom, which I have already discussed. Radius of the hydrogen atom. So this formula also gives the radius of the hydrogen atom, also known as the Bohr radius. This is the classical radius. By eliminating R from these equations, we can find the velocity, and eliminating V gives the possible radii Rn. So this is the general radius for all the energy levels. If we put n equal to 1 to 3, we get the all energy levels radius. For example, find the radius of the hydrogen atom in its most stable orbit, that is ground state. And for the ground state, n equal to 1. This is the Bohr radius. And after calculating, we get the radius is 53.1 picometer, simply 0.53 angstrom. Total energy of an atom. The total energy at cell level n is the sum of kinetic and potential energy at that level. So E equal to K plus U, K equal half mv square, and U equal E square upon 4 pi epsilon r. We recall that. And after putting and solving, we get the final expression as for the energy eigenvalue or total energy of an atom for hydrogen. En equal minus m e power 4 8 epsilon naught square n square h square. Energy for a particular state. It will be useful to simplify the energy formula for a particular state by substitution of constant. And these are the constants: mass of electron, epsilon naught, relative permittivity, absolute permittivity. E is the electron charge. Charge of electron, H is the Planck constant. And finally, we get in joule minus 2.17 into 10 power minus 18 joule upon n square. So also remember this formula. And in electron volt, generally expressed in atomic scale, energy in electron volt. So in electron volt, this energy is given by minus 13.6 electron volt upon n square. So we can put n equal to 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. To find the any energy levels, energy for any energy levels. I hope it will be clear to all of you. So must remember this relation, these relations and these relations. Also the relation of this relation. Because these relations also tells which relation is proportional to which quantities. So must remember these relations. Baumer revisited. The total energy of hydrogen atom for level n, that is equal to this negative energy, because outside energy rests n levels. When an electron moves from an initial state ni to a final state nf, energy involved is this much. So here is some distraction, so you can skip this. So Balmer equation is this 1 upon lambda equal r 1 upon nf square minus n naught square. So this is the final and original, and Rydberg constant ki value hoti 1.097 into 10 power 7 meter minus 1. Energy level we can now visualize the hydrogen atom with an electron at many possible energy levels. So as the relation is E equal minus 13.6 electron volt upon n square, so if we use the change in energy of the atoms can be given in terms of initial and final levels, that is ni and nf, then the energy of nth level, yeah, energy of, yes, simply we can say change in energy here. So change in energy E equal to minus 13.6 electron volt 1 upon nf square minus m1 upon n naught square. Spectral series for an atom, the Lyman series is for transition to n equal to 1 level, Balmer series to n equal to 2 level, Poisson series similarly n equal to 3 levels, bracket n equal to 4 levels. So the yellow line showing the Lyman series, this is Lyman, and red line is Balmer. Clear? What is the energy of an emitted photon if an electron drops from the n equal to 3 level to n equal to 1 level for hydrogen atom? So we can use simply this formula and putting the values of initial and final number. So nf equal to 1 and n0 equal to 3. So this will give the change in energy minus 12.1 electron volt. And this energy of atom decreases by 12.1 electron volt as a photon of that energy is emitted. So you should know that the 13.6 electron volt is the required to move an electron for n equal to 1 to n equal to infinite. So this energy is required to move an electron from n equal to 1 to n equal to infinite, that is ground state to infinite. Modern theory of atoms, the models of an electron as a point particle moving in a circular orbit has undergone significant change. So the quantum model now represent the location of an electron as a probability distribution, a cloud around the nucleus like that. An additional quantum number has been added to describe such as things as a shape orientation. So naya atomic number, additional atomic number add kiya gaya hai kuch things ko janne ke liye, jaise shapes, orientation aur magnetic spin. Pauli exclusion principle also so that the no two electron in an atom can exist in the same state, in exact same state, that is no two electron can have the all quantum numbers are same, that is Pauli rule. Modern atomic theory, the Bohr atom for beryllium suggests a planetary model which is not strictly correct. For n equal to 2 level of the hydrogen atom shown, there is a here as a probability distribution. This is quantum mechanically. So summary of all the things, Bohr models of the atoms assume the electron to follow a circular orbit around the positive nucleus. And the formula is the radius of hydrogen atom is this, r equal to e square upon 4 pi epsilon naught mv square. So must remember these formulas. Also, in an electron spectrum, characteristic wavelength appears on a screen. For an absorption spectrum, certain wavelengths are emitted. So these are the emission spectra. This is the emission spectra. And also the Balmer spectrum. This is the Balmer equation. We have already discussed all these things. Bohr model, see the hydrogen atom. And this is also discussed earlier. But these formulas are very, very important for the entrance point of view. Lots of questions are asking from these formulas. So this is all about for today. I hope this is very useful for all of you. And I think you understand all of the things. Thanks for watching video. Thank you.